The new CDC guidance on masks is again highlighting the partisan divide all over this country when it comes to the politics of the pandemic. As David Leonhardt from the New York Times writes, the parts of the country that would benefit most from a new crackdown on COVID-19, including more frequent mask wearing, are also the places least likely to follow CDC guidance. Many of these communities have been rejecting the advice of medical experts for months on both masks and vaccines. And if you want to get a sense of how partisan the issue has become, look no further than the House floor earlier today when a new mask mandate was met with extreme opposition from Republicans.
It's absolutely absurd what this body is doing, the People's House. It's an embarrassment. It's a mockery. And the American people are fed up. They want to go back to life. They want to go back to business. They want to go back to school without their children being forced to wear masks.
And with us now is Yamiche Alcindor, PBS NewsHour White House correspondent and moderator of Washington Week. And Michael Steele joins us as well. He's former RNC chairman and former lieutenant governor of Maryland. So, Yamiche, we'll start with you. The Biden administration, and I know you know this to be true based on your own reporting, they've made a big push to build this wall between politics and public health policy. To their credit, that's how it's supposed to work. But the unintended consequence of that it has left the administration somewhat flat-footed when it comes to messaging. And we saw that this past week with this CDC messaging about masks that has been widely criticized as being confusing.
That's right. The Biden administration and President Biden have really underscored that they're going to follow the science and not let politics play into this. But we have to just underscore that the people who would benefit the most from the CDC guidance that was updated just a day ago are the same people who are least likely to follow that guidance, the people who are unvaccinated, the people who don't want to wear masks. They're largely Republicans, largely white male conservative voters who are looking at these guidance and thinking that there's some sort of conspiracy against their freedoms. The original sin of this pandemic from a government standpoint was politicizing it. It was this idea that President Biden's predecessor, former President Trump, that he politicized the idea of wearing masks, that he floated all sorts of issues when it came to what could actually treat the coronavirus. And then finally, when the vaccine that he had been pushing scientists to develop, when it was finally ready, he didn't do the real work of trying to convince his supporters to get vaccinated and left states flat-footed when it came to how to distribute that vaccine. So, of course, the Biden administration now is having to contend with the idea that they're having to tell vaccinated people that they told, if you follow the rules, you'll be able to get this great thing in July, which is a sense of normalcy and your masks off. That is all now being reversed. You can see it when you talk to sources at the White House here. When I talk to sources at the White House, you can hear the frustration in their voices, the concern in their voices, because we are now nowhere near where the president wanted to be in this part of the summer.
And Michael, to Yamiche's great point, according to a new Axios Ipsos poll, a whopping 45% of unvaccinated Americans who are not at all likely to get a COVID vaccine are Republicans. Compare that to just 12% of the same group who are Democrats. And I think Yamiche and I both were in the briefing room back in April of 2020, back when Donald Trump used to hold those hours-long briefings, and it was the day that they announced the CDC recommendation for wearing masks. And President Trump at the time said, it's voluntary. I don't see myself doing it. He said, you know, the idea that I'd be wearing a mask and meeting with other presidents and prime ministers, I just don't see that happening. And you could argue that that was the moment where this became political. Help us understand how it stayed that way, how it stayed political, all of this whole pandemic.
Well, I think Yamiche and her reporting puts it all very straightforwardly. It stayed political because a lot of Republicans, hewing to the maniacal medicine of Donald Trump, continue to spew the lie about the masks. And that got wrapped up in this concept or ideas around conspiracies, perpetrated by crazy QAnoners out there like Marjorie Taylor Greene. And so you have this reinforcement of the negative narrative. The Biden administration coming in the gate hamstrung from a shortened, transition with the outgoing administration because, again, Trump's team didn't want to cooperate, had to hit the ground running with very little runway to sort of rebuild, the rebrand, and recommunicate on this particular narrative. The other problem, and you reported on this and you covered it in the earlier segments, is that you have also the CDC putting out information that at times doesn't seem well-defined. So that just makes it easier for the numbnuts out there to start, you know, to clamor on about, oh, see, they don't know. And now, you know, they're coming for your Bibles. They, you know, when they knock on your door to ask if you want to get a vaccine. So it just gets wrapped up in a whole new ball of crazy. And unfortunately, here we are. The vaccinated are going to have to learn how to deal with the unvaccinated. And that could lead to a lot of tensions this fall across the states as this thing continues to explode, because you've got it being pushed out by a lot of people who just refuse to get vaccinated or even wear a mask.
Well, let me ask you this, Michael Steele, in the minute that we have left. You understand Republican messaging better than most as the former chairman of the RNC. How could Democrats best sort of rob Republicans of that opening, of stepping into that void created by this sort of confusing messaging about masks, and sort of move forward?
Well, I think, first off, I think you just got to, you know, the administration has to nail down the CDC and just put the plan on the table and just kind of be very straightforward about what that is. The second thing is, you're not going to move, to Yamiche's reporting, you're not going to move a lot of these white male Republicans off of this point. They are stuck with Trump on this, and they will stay with Trump on this. So it's play to everybody else. And you can have some success there, but it's going to require a constant message and some steady hand in leadership.
All right, Michael Steele and Yamiche Alcindor, my thanks to the both of you, and our thanks to you as well for spending the hour with us.